So they are going to be starting clinical trials at different time points.
While updating the country on the progress of the project of developing the COVID-19 vaccine this evening, scientists led by Dr. Monica Msenero, the Minister of Science, Technology and Innovation, said all is set to embark on the clinical trials of the vaccines, and at this stage, they are starting with trials on the mice. These special mice, which were ordered from abroad, are expected in the country any time. They are four in number, two male and two female.
Now, for most of these science things that we buy, they do the work, then they get intellectual property, and they get a patent. So when somebody has that patent, they need permission to use, even if I know your technology, I cannot just use it to develop something here.
It's the outcome of the clinical trials on these mice that will determine the next course of action, which includes carrying out trials on humans, a process expected to last a period of between 6 to 8 months. Msenero dismissed allegations that her ministry misappropriated the funds meant for the project. She clarified that Parliament appropriated 31 billion shillings for the project, but the Ministry of Finance only released 28 billion. 7 billion shillings was spent on the vaccine, and the rest of other money went to cover other projects.
There is no single shilling which has been misappropriated. The Auditor General has audited these funds twice, and those funds, they have not shown any single money.
She further pointed out that even the World Health Organization is to send an oversight technical team in the country this month, which will work alongside with the scientists in charge of developing this vaccine to help give guidance.
So Preside is coordinating with the World Health Organization, with the National Drug Authority, with the Bureau of Standards here, but not only so, we are helping to coordinate with people who bring in the machines that we need, who bring in the technology that we need, so that we build the national capacity comprehensively.
Meanwhile, the Ministry of Health has announced that Uganda is out of the COVID-19 third wave outbreak following steady reduction in the positivity rate. The Minister of Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, says currently the country has only four districts where COVID cases are being registered, and these are Kampala, Wakiso, Kabarole, and Mpiji. To enhance their fight against the deadly pandemic, the Ministry of Health has received a donation of 1,000 oxygen cylinders worth $23,000 from the Danish Embassy and the World Health Organization. During the occasion, it was noted that despite the reduction of the COVID-19 infections in Uganda, the country needs a robust oxygen gas supply system to increase the survival rate of critically ill patients.
Oxygen is a critical commodity that one needs when you are sick, and it has to be available and available on time.
It was here that the Minister of Health, Jane Ruth Acheng, revealed that Uganda is out of the third COVID-19 wave.
We are out of the third wave, and I can comfortably say that we are out of the third wave. The positivity rate is very low, at almost just 1%. All over the country, there is no district in alert phase, there is no district in response phase.
At the height of the second wave, the country had to go to neighboring Kenya to get oxygen cylinders. Medical professionals say hundreds of liters can last just 3 days for patients who cannot breathe on their own. The cylinders cost 808 million shillings. Wow.